good early evening from Washington, D.C. We arrived here a few hours ago from Dulles. We had to take a shuttle bus to another metro station because the metro station at the airport was not closed. That one wasn't closed, but there was a few other ones that were closed along the route, so we weren't allowed to ride it the whole way through, so we had to take a shuttle bus to Rosslyn, Virginia, where we got on the metro. And there's the Capitol. I'm gonna be here for a few days, and then we're gonna move on up the coast. So today we're probably gonna today we're gonna go down to the Capitol, and later we're gonna go the other way. Or tomorrow we're gonna go the other way to where all the memorials are, and then on Tuesday we'll go to all the museums. Well, not all of them, but some of them. And this building right here is the Department of Education building. And up here is obviously the Capitol building. It's covered in scaffolding and scrim. Obviously, they're doing construction. And the other direction, further down the National Mall, is the Washington Memorial, all the way down there. And we'll probably go and see that tomorrow. According to Google Maps, this is the Ulysses S. Grant Monument or Memorial. I believe these are noble sites. I can't tell if this is something you're supposed to be able to drink from. I wouldn't, but it's there. There's people up there. I don't know if they're politicians or if they're just tourists that just happen to be dressed up. There's people with there's guys with white hair, so they're probably politicians. And of course they have the super American Chevy Suburbans outside the Capitol. Cool. And here is the Supreme Court building. This is First Street, I guess. Saw some Danish people.
And what they have been doing is meeting in the U.S. Capitol. Thought if they're going to vote on whether or not rules are valid,
This marble I assume. And maybe. I'm not sure. I know some of the marble from the Lincoln Memorial comes from the town of Marble in Colorado, which we have in fact been to. I wonder if this costs a lot to maintain, or if it's just... Well, it's really easy. Or if they pressure wash it every day. Some really tall doors up here. Cool. And here is the Library of Congress. Right across from the Capitol over there. I'll get a better view on the other side. But, I don't know what this has to do with that. Neptune, maybe? Good morning from Washington, D.C. This here building is part of the Smithsonian. I don't know what specifically they have in here, but we'll figure it out in a second. And then there's the Department of Energy building. Pretty much all the department buildings are kind of boring because they're just office buildings and they look like they come out of Soviet Russia.
What's
that? Fiona Gardner. Apparently, this was a part of a civil rights movement. Protest, I guess you could say. Demonstration. In Baltimore, and they moved it here. And it was on the same day as the I Have a Dream speech. So apparently this is 555 feet tall. I have no idea what that is in metric, so I'll just put it in there because American flags. I would go up and like touch it, but I'm sure a gazillion people have done that. So. White House down there. Super sick. I have a lot of these like gate things, so most people can't just access government buildings by a road, although it seems like you can just walk straight in, so I think it's just to manage car traffic. There's a lot of big lawns here. Apparently this is the National Christmas Tree. I think it said 1923 was when it was first lit, not this specific tree, but this specific tree's been there since 1973. I literally just saw the sign, but I don't remember what they said. It's either 73 or 75, but I think it was 73. So. And right across from the White House, which you can't see because of trees. Now here's the White House. But at the moment you can't go straight up to it. This kind of sucks, but security, I guess. I mean, that guy literally has a rifle, so. There's a lot of bike infrastructure around here, but it seems very inconsistent. So a lot of people will cycle on the walkways. It's good to see that they are trying to make a change. Not first. Not entirely sure, but I'm assuming since there's literally a Red Cross right on there, that this is probably the Red Cross headquarters. The memory of the heroic women of the Civil War. I think there would be a plaque. There is no plaque inside. I wonder if that's the museum. No. The National Society of the Daughters of the American Revolution. There's a lot of people honking. And not very nice drivers around here. And here's the headquarters of the OAS, which is like a, I don't know what you call it. Like, I don't think it's a trade organization, it's like a foreign affairs organization between all the countries of the Americas and I think a few countries in the Caribbean. In terms of
safety, I've often heard that Washington DC is very dangerous, but I haven't really felt uncomfortable at all here. There are a few homeless people, but nothing compared to back home in California, so as long as you're paying attention, you will be fine. Lincoln Memorial down there, and the reflecting pool, which doesn't really appear to be reflecting much.
I think this is probably the center. There's a little piece of concrete block right there, and I have no idea what that's from, but there's the butt of a duck. check and see if there's actually exhibits down here. Where's the buttons? Hopefully it opens. It just kind of spits you out here, right in front of the memorial. It's trying to make a loop, so we're probably going to go that way now. Making our way down to the Martin Luther King Jr. Memorial, or monument. Which long Independence Avenue. There are like pedestrian lights, but it's kind of scary-ish crossing them, so just keep in mind you'll have to wait a while to cross. The fact that it's carved out of this thing, or taken out from this thing, is supposed to reflect the quote, and with the mountain of despair, the stone of hope. I'll be over there in a second. It isn't nearly as crowded as other monuments. The quotes on the other side. There's also a water feature on each side of the mountain carving. I believe this here is the Tidal Basin. It's a man-made body of water. Looks like a nice place to walk. Probably a lot of bugs, though. For being out the swamp, this is probably the most swampy part that I've actually seen. Some cool views of the skyline. There's lots of flooding on both sides. Smithsonian, Jefferson Memorial, Washington Memorial, monument. I don't know what that tower building is next to it, but cool. And up here, there's some geese. I don't know if it's the best idea to walk near them, though. There's kind of no choice. This one's the FDR Memorial, I believe. Yeah, I'm looking up here, but here it's not. Very spread out. There's an open quote. Faces etched and engraved into these holes. Here's the patron section. Seems that everything's starting to fall apart. Dog. I don't remember his name, but and I assume this is the start of the fourth term. I didn't see the engravings on the ground, and I assume that at some point there used to be water running down here. My quotes. Anyway, this is all managed by National Park Service. Oh, look. Oh, I thought that was something important, but it is actually a trash can. There's Eleanor Roosevelt. From what I gather, I don't know if this is actually what it's about, but from what I gather from all this, the sentence, it seems that it's chronicling the deterioration of its health. Because it keeps breaking further and further in pieces.
Currently, it is under construction.
But it says it's open, so we'll go around the side.
It's right by the water.
I believe that's still Arlington, but it could be a different part of Virginia because there's a lot of areas with skyscrapers right outside the city. But I think it's better to take a picture of this from the side-ish instead of like straight in front, because you can't see how it curves from straight on. So now we're gonna go up into it.
Still less crowded than the other monuments, but it's still
quite a bit of people. Can't really control that.
Yep.
It says don't stamp the walls, and as you can see, nobody listened. And there's some brochures and stuff.
This is in the pool shop. On the side. As you can see, and again, people don't listen to the quiet part either. But that's the reality of tourist attractions. And here's another bridge to get back into the main part of Washington, D.C. This is the first freeway we've seen today. Up there. But there aren't really any freeways in Washington, D.C. One that goes under, but unlike LA or pretty much anywhere else, there's not really any that sort of thing. Still pretty car infested, but not too bad.